A child who spends 13 years in average public schools has one chance in roughly 107,000 of a violent death in school, on school property, or while commuting to school. 83% of the school victims and 96% of the offenders were male.
Today is.
You hired one more shot and want anything to eat, Will?
No, I picked at that leftover pasta a couple hours ago.
I thought I heard you up.
Yeah, I couldn't sleep, so I thought I'd get some work done.
Were you writing?
Well, I was trying.
Anything I can do to help?
No. It's something I gotta go through alone.
Hey, I thought you said real writers don't try to write, they just write.
I used to think that. Maybe it's true. I sure was trying last night. So what the hell does that tell you?
Hell.
Right. Just when I got him to stop saying shit.
Shit.
Hey, James. Why don't you go outside and bring in your toys like I asked you to yesterday? I almost fell and broke my ass on him, pal.
Ass.
Oh, James. Dara will be home late by herself. Dinner, love, Mom. Don't forget to take your medication.
Speak.
What? It's
Dara.
Dara, hey. What's shaking?
Me. I need some meth you're holding.
Yeah, it might be. What are you holding?
50. Hmm. Hello? Sounds good. Where should I meet you?
Your usual place. Right before homeroom.
All right. Solid.
Hey, baby, what are you wearing?
Hello? Hello,
Karen!
Yes, Dad?
Was it your phone ringing?
Was it? I didn't hear it.
What's up, Daddy?
Just leaving for school. Wanted to see if you needed a ride.
Oh, Tommy's picking me up. I'm good.
Well, make sure you stay good. I know how those football players are.
Daddy, I think I can handle Tommy.
See you after school. And, Karen, don't be late. Just because it's the last day, it's no excuse to be tardy. Hmm?
Thank you, Principal Lewis. Goodbye.
Bye.
Oh! It's fucking Lewis, man. You just look young, Lewis.
Guy could use a fuck you. He acts like he fucking owns the place.
Oh, he does do that, don't he?
My mother's tax dollars pay his fucking checks. He's a fucking civil servant.
Oh, I'd like to make that daughter his last servant.
Now, she's worthy of the Ricky Herman special.
Yeah. What's that doing? Fuck you, Doug.
I told your mother I was stressed out that morning, the mouthy fucking bitch. Got the bet, Paul. It's one more in it. Last day of school. Make it count.
Fuckers.
If you want to.
Don't you?
Robin, don't you?
I said sure, Kev.
I'll see you in a while, okay?
I feel fat.
Come on.
That's impossible. I'll see you in a bit.
Okay, Kev, see you.
Everyone else has a normal kid. Me, I got fucking Dark Lord. Well, you'll learn, Danielle. After today, things are gonna change for you in a major fucking way. Last day of high school, I haven't seen no acceptance letters from colleges rolling in, have you?
It's because I didn't apply to any.
That's my boy. Well, you know what? Starting Monday, you're in for a rude fucking awakening. It's called work. Because if you ain't going to school, you are going to be busting your ass to bring a buck into this household. You got that, buddy boy?
Talk to me about it Monday.
You know, I got an idea for you. Why don't you just enjoy today? Because there ain't gonna be too many more fun in the fucking sun days for you anytime real soon.
Yeah. It's been heaven.
Okay. I called Judy. She can cover for me. It's probably not gonna take very long, huh?
I really don't.
What's your principal's name again?
Mr. Lewis.
Mr. Lewis.
God. Wait, you're gonna see Mr. Lewis today?
Yeah, I told you that last week, didn't I?
I don't think...
You don't think what? You come home with bruises on your face. What do you want me to do? Nobody does that to my son.
Listen to me, Ma. Don't go to school today. Just go to work. Please?
Nice try. I gotta get a move on.
Yeah. Go down, baby. Shut up.
Hey, man.
You asshole.
Shut up.
Give me a hit of that. Michelle. So how come you ain't at work?
If anything I learned in my 23 years of living in this shithole is that there's more to life than work. You remember that, Ricky? You guys too. Am I right, Lenny?
You're right. You're right.
I think Bob would have something different to say about that.
Fuck, Rick, she's hotter than I am right now. What's she gonna say, right? Besides, me missing my, 4 hours of minimum wage, and when they say minimum, they mean minimum. I promise I ain't gonna throw the delicate balance of our economy out of whack. Someone else could fucking, you know, pump their gas and wash their windshields. Me, I can sit right back, suck on this fat joint. World's still gonna spin. Right, Lenny?
Oh, you're right. You're right.
Didn't you used to play football, man?
Yeah, for like a half a year, and then the bastard quit.
Oh, fuck that. I just found better things to do. My fucking time is all. Pussy. PlayStation. Prescription. Pills!
Triple P.
My Len?
You're right. You're right.
I'll tell you, though, when I did play, I fucking catch everything they threw. Give me the ball. Everything they threw at me, I fucking had some hands on me, you know what I'm saying? All the Hermans got hands. Let me see your hand.
These hands?
Yeah, let me see that shit.
What the fuck did you do to them?
Did you get in a fight?
Not exactly. Start up. Listen to this, man.
Early bird catches the worm, huh?
Save the Proverbs, be a good little dealer, and chuck me some shit, okay?
Girl knows what she wants. You okay?
I will be when you give me that bag. I mean, unless you want to play shrink and ask me about my fucking childhood. You want to ask me about my fucking childhood? Because I got lots to say about it.
You want to smoke it, snort it, swallow it?
Will it affect me faster?
Ice? Smoke it. You got gear? Is this real?
Mommy doesn't give me fake money. If she did, we might have an actual conversation.
I'll take your word for it, then.
Take whatever you want, everyone else does. I'm gonna go.
All right. Have a nice trip. Shit.
Mr. Presley. Would you mind coming with me?
I'd love to.
Tommy, we can't.
Come on.
Lovely.
Doesn't this feel good?
Not the point, Tiger. Of course it feels good. But you wouldn't do it if it didn't feel good.
I can feel how fucking hard you make me, can't you?
When you put my hand on there, I can, yeah.
Come on, like, it's the last day of school, okay? Something old ending, something new beginning. I want to be inside you.
Tommy, I told you 1,000 times. I'm not ready for it. This isn't negotiable. Can't talk me into this, honey. Besides, it's not like we don't do other things.
Other things? Other things. Like that's an answer. You know what?
What?
Never mind. Doesn't even matter.
Tommy, what?
Look, we should talk, maybe.
Hey, Harold, what kind of school are you running here? No milk, no half and half? It's like working in a sweatshop here.
There's no dairy creamer right there. This is a high school, Will, not Starbucks.
Yeah, I know. Starbucks pays better.
You're here. You look tired, Will. Did sarcasm class last night?
I thought you were teaching that class now.
At least he's teaching something.
I couldn't sleep. I was up at 4 a.m. trying to get some work done.
You still writing that book?
Yeah, I'm still writing that book. I should have just taken another Xanax and went back to bed, though.
We should talk, maybe.
It's one of those days you really remember, you know? I'd like to take some of this day with me.
Listen, this is what I was thinking.
You spend 4 years waiting for the day to come. The day to get out of here. You start your life, you become a grown-up.
Robin.
And the day comes, and you're like, where the hell did all the time go? 4 years, Kev. 4 years.
I'm with you 100%.
What happened? Kevin, what happened? Where the hell are my keys? Have you seen my keys?
I don't know, Ma. Did you check your purse?
Did I check my purse? Did I check my purse? Shit, they're not in here.
Just relax. Have a cup of coffee.
Like I need another cup of coffee. What am I supposed to do?
You're supposed to get your shit together. And I don't just mean your keys and your purse. And you're supposed to catch the bus and make it to work. You'll find your keys when you come home tonight.
Think so?
I'm sure of it.
Sometimes I wonder which one of us is the kid and which is the adult. I'm sorry, I'm a bad mom.
Not
mom. No, if your father were still here, things would be different, they would.
I'd leave you.
Before he left, I swear, I was...
Ma, you should get going. The bus usually runs slow, and why should Judy cover for you if you can make it in on time? Save the favor for another day.
Okay, you're right. Makes sense.
I really do love you, Ma.
You never say it first. I love you too, Barry. I love you like crazy. I'm sorry. I really wanted to help take care of this for you, though.
It's okay. I can take care of it on my own.
That's your future. I told Gus Flint you'd give him a call over the weekend.
Who the fuck is Gus Flint?
Hey! When did I give you permission to start cursing in this household, huh?
Well, if I'm gonna be treated like an adult around here, then I should be able to say what I want.
Fair enough. But you get out of line with it, and my hand comes across your mouth.
So who's Gus Flint?
Huh? He owns my construction company. He said he'd give you a job. Carrying bags of cement. It'll put some muscle tone on you. Jesus Christ, last time I saw arms like that, they were in a coffin. But you know what? Gus is a good man. And if you hunt bags of cement for him for a couple months, he'll give you a tryout on heavy equipment. So don't try to snake yourself out of it here, huh? You already said yes.
Really?
Hey!
When did I say yes?
You weren't there.
You know what, Dad? I'm stronger than you think.
Yeah? What are all those red marks on your face, son? Hickeys?
I'm stronger than you think.
Yeah. I'll believe it when I see it. Call a fucking number.
Yeah. Let me ask you something, Wicks. What's your question, Vanessa?
My name is Mrs. Jones.
I know.
Why, Rex? Just tell me why. Why? Why?
It's easy, easy. What are we doing, the alphabet here? You want to try numbers next?
Oh, you want to try numbers? Well, try this one. You scored over 1,400 on your SATs. Did you know that?
I opened my mail.
Your teacher suspects you are a near genius IQ, but of course, you're not in class often enough to tell.
Sometimes the day just gets away from me.
You mean business gets in your way, don't you?
That too.
Vanessa, are you looking to score? What do you mean? Because whenever you want, I got it. And if not, give me a day and I can get it.
Just shut up and stand up. Stand up!
Oh, fuck, Rick, I used to do that shit all the time, man.
Fuck, some of those Frank Herman stories are fucking legendary, man. Yeah.
You think?
Nah, fuck, man, I never did nothing too bad to nobody.
Hey!
What, Len?
That's right. Nothing too bad.
I got this bastard to carry the torch, huh?
Just keeping the tradition alive, man. Little whiny, skinny fucks. Can't throw a ball, drink no beer. Tapping away on your little computers. Just learning.
Shit, man. Some of those kids should just wear a fucking kick me sign on their back, you know?
Make it easier on us.
Yeah.
Who are the kids you fucked with, Ricky?
Huh?
Shit, dick. What is that?
Shit, dick.
What is that? You got
what are you writing on your
you
locker?
You got a shitty dick. What's going on?
Leave me alone! Leave me alone!
Working on your lesson plan?
Yeah, sure.
Will, would you relax, man? Everyone knows what you're working on. Nobody cares.
I know, and that's the problem.
Why, it's not going so well?
Define your terms.
Are you happy with it?
No.
Would anyone else enjoy reading
it? I doubt it.
Any chance a publisher might publish it?
Not a one.
Not going so well.
No, not really. I don't know, maybe it's true what they say. Those who can do, those who can't.
Well, I teach sex education, so what are you trying to say?
It's a funny line, Ryan. Very clever. Maybe you should take a stab at writing.
No, that's gotta be hard, man, because, I mean, you're a creative writing teacher. But then you're in a slump in your own writing. So, I mean, that's got to be frustrating. That's like, I mean, I don't know. That's enough to drive a man nuts.
Thanks for your help, Brian.
I mean, that'd be like me not being able to get a hard on, right?
Will?
Yeah.
Got a minute? Let's go for a walk.
Sure.
Get out of here.
What do you think? You want to start heading over there? First bell's gonna ring in half an hour.
What I want? What I wanted last week? What I wanted last night? What I wanted since we got here is to talk to you.
What do you want to talk about, Kevin? Do you want to talk about names? For a boy, I like Jack. For a girl, I like Melissa. You want to talk about gender? Who cares as long as it's healthy, right? That's the rule. You want to talk about size? I was hoping for 6 pounds or less because I'm the one who has to squeeze it out from between my legs. Or do you want to talk about what the hell happens to the rest of my life, not to mention my body, when this kid comes to town? Because the thought of giving up my 20s to spoon feed some rugrat is enough to make me want to fucking shake. What do you want to talk about, Kevin?
I want to talk about whether or not we're going to have this baby.
Oh, is that all?
Look, Karen, look, I'm sorry, I'm trying to think how to say this here.
Just say it, Tommy. Just be honest.
Okay, look, we're about to graduate, right? Move on to college. We're going to start experiencing new things. Meet new people. Kind of wave goodbye to our old lives and hello to a different one.
Tommy, what is all this? Old stuff, new stuff.
Well, look, Kara, we've been together now for 3 years, right? That's a long time. I think maybe we should maybe start seeing...
Are you breaking up with me?
Look, I just think we should...
Are you breaking up with me?
Yeah.
What?
I said yes.
You're serious?
Yeah.
This is because I won't sleep with you, isn't it? That's what this is all about?
Look, Karen, I'm gonna be 18 in a couple of months, all right? I'm older than you.
By 5 months? Tommy. Look, okay, sweetie, maybe we need to talk about this for a minute, okay? I know this couldn't have been easy for you. Not having sex. That was my idea. And because you loved me so much, you agreed to hold on to your virginity, too. I never thought about how hard this must be on you. Tommy, please don't get upset. It's okay.
Kara, how could you be so naive?
You want I should strip down, turn around, bend over? You want to send the dogs in here to sniff my crotch? Easy there, Vanessa. Take this any further, and I'm gonna have your house.
Don't touch that.
You know, to be honest with you, I'm really enjoying this side of you.
Pleasure's mine.
First, it's free. What can I do you for?
What? Sit down.
Come over here, stand up, sit down. Least you could do is say something sense.
Do you know what this shit is doing to my school?
You're a fucking guidance counselor, all right? You're not the mayor of Happy Town here. It's hardly your school.
Well, it is more my school than it is your street corner.
I got a list of names of people around here who say different.
You're so bright, Wex, but pushing this shit on impressionable kids who are not as smart as you.
Look, I give people a little grass, a little crank, something to put them on a nice little trip, all right? That's not much different than the one that you put them on. You help expand people's minds. So do I.
You have no idea what you're doing to these kids.
Neither do you. Besides, what's the worst that can happen?
Too young, Wex. Can't believe how bad things can get.
What
Just like I thought. Mrs. Jones' door is locked again. Her door is always locked.
Yeah, I know.
What the hell goes on in there? I like to get an appointment with Miss Jones. Well, if not, I'd like to get an appointment with you, Ms. Weinberg. What do you think about that, huh, baby?
Morning, Beth.
Morning, Janice.
Every morning of the last day of school is a good morning.
What do you need, Beth? Is he in?
Yes, he is, with Will Pratt. But that just got in there a couple of minutes ago, so go knock and see what he says.
Okay, thanks, Janice. Last day.
Last day.
Come on in.
Morning, Harold. Will?
Hi, Beth. What do you have for me?
Final absent reports of the year.
Thank you.
Last day.
I'm sorry, Will. But when these calls come in, I have to look into it. Otherwise, I'm not doing my job.
As opposed to me not doing mine?
Nobody is questioning whether you do your job or not.
Well, what are they saying?
Maybe a little rough on the kids.
Rough? As in I hit them?
Not physically, Will. I think your criticism of the students' work is a little harsh.
Harold, I teach creative writing. How do I do that unless I critique the work that they hand in?
But it has to be evaluated on a fair scale. I think that's what these complaints are in response to. And that's what we have to explore.
Explore all you want. What do you want to know?
How's your book going, Will?
Where'd you get this weed, Ricky? It's better than the shit I get. This guy Wax. He's always holding. I think he grows it himself. Let me tell you, boys, enjoy the rest of your time here, all right? You're gonna miss it, okay? It's good to know, little brother, the apple don't fall far from the tree. Pop's tree. Yeah.
Yeah. Ricky's got a real knack with people.
Yeah. He's a person people.
People person, asshole.
Hey, so Frank, like, what's the craziest shit you ever did? I mean, craziest.
Oh, man, I don't know. I don't think about that shit no more.
Oh, come on, Frankie, tell us, man. We got shit to do.
Anything you bring to mind, Lenny? Snap out of it, Spicoli. These kids want a crazy story. They want a story about the craziest shit I did during my time here. Think about it.
It's Lil White.
I was thinking the same thing all along.
Whoa. What's Lil White? It's not a what.
It's a who. Slowell is why.
The nickname was Slow White because she was kind of slow in the head. You know, I don't think she was retarded technically or nothing like that, but she was well on her way. Right, Lenny?
He's right. Oh,
so, listen, we were playing stickball with little Joe B's driveway. We used to always get out there after school, you know? So it was me, Joe, Dave, and this guy, Jake. Jake, yeah. And so we'd be out there, and, you know, his parents were always at work, so we'd always have the driveway free, right? And this one afternoon, we're finishing up a quick four innings, right? Getting ready to go inside, have a few of Big Joe B's beers, you know what I'm saying? Went up rides. Slow as what? She's about 16, same as us. She don't go to our school. I guess they ain't equipped to deal with her kind. But, you know, she comes around, though. She watches us play. And she might be kind of fucked up, right? But she's also got this mad killer body. You know what I'm saying? Like, whatever guy left out of her head, he slapped on her chest. You know what I'm saying? Like, boom! So she came by, and, you know, we're playing, we're finishing up. And I thought I'd be a nice guy. You know, I got a hot, you know? So I'm like, hey, you want to come in? You want to have a beer? Whole face lit up, right? Excited. It's the greatest thing that ever happened to her, right? So we end up in the basement. We're, you know, we're knocking them back. We're feeling good. We got our 12. Well, I got my 12 back. And, Dave drops some smooth tunes. DJ Mix Master Dave. Yeah. We couldn't resist this opportunity. So we're like, listen, hey, Alice, you know, we'd like to see some. You want to get up? You want to dance for us? Bam! Like that. Got up, started dancing, right? Oh, she's shaking a groovy thing, like, She looked a little silly, want to know the truth. You know, you can imagine the rhythm, but it was fucking funny, right? No one was complaining. It was fucking funny, right? So, you know, we start dancing with her. You know?
Well, everybody except Jay fucking guy takes right out, but, you know, me, Jones, we keep switching. We're spinning around the floor. We're feeling good. She looks good, too. Nate Joe, crazy fuck, starts making out with her. Girl's not resisting, right? Girl is not resisting. So Joe takes her shirt off. No bra. Girl that she was there for. Like, just boom. Like, she's not like, you know, I'm going over there. Has anything my bra? You know, she's all right. Whole time. Then I get to it. I lay it down. On the sofa. Put my hand between the legs. She starts to go wild. I didn't need to feel how wet she was because I could smell it. She had this look. And put it inside, she had this look. It's almost like a shock look. Like she wasn't expecting this, like this. This was a surprise. Then she just kind of had this blank expression. You know, like she was really trying to concentrate. Enjoy it. So then I go and I finish up. Dave hops out and he finishes up. Joe hops out and he finishes up. Man, we were some crazy fuckers that day. You know? Yeah. It's fucking wild. Wild fucking Wednesday, you know what I'm saying? So we send her off, you know. We tell her she shouldn't tell nobody about it. Don't keep it zipped, you know what I'm saying? And then, you know, she told her parents, though. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, you could expect it. That's all right. She was kind of proud of it. But the cool thing about that chick, she never said who it was. She was discreet. I can appreciate that.
Bam! Fucking like that.
Yeah, I heard about that. That was you?
Yeah, man, it was.
I heard that stickball bat got involved.
Fucking rumors, man.
It's just rumors, Ricky. So, like I said, enjoy your time here while you can.
Why are we walking this way? We can just double back and cut through the soccer field. Come on.
Add a half mile to the trip. Why? For what?
You know why and you know for what.
Yeah. Well, that reason sucks. I'm sick of this shit, Barry.
I know you are. What?
No. I fucking mean it. I'm really sick of this. I'm home. I take shit from my father every stupid goddamn day. Like it was his second job. And there's nothing I can do about that. I come here. I take shit from these ignorant motherfuckers who shouldn't even be allowed to wipe my ass. Much less kick it over and over again.
And there's nothing you can do about that either.
Yeah, well, I might argue with you on that. There's stuff that can be done.
Okay, well, let's not start worrying about that now. We got a couple more weeks left, and then it's over forever.
We really left our mark here, didn't we? That's 12 years of beatings and degrading bullshit. This crap's been going on since the first fucking grade. What's our legacy? We saw, we came, we got pissed on weekly? Fuck that. I don't know about you, but I'm gonna walk where I wanna walk, Barry. And if you had an ounce of respect for yourself, you'd walk right beside me.
Like I said, we got a couple more weeks left and then it's a fresh start.
Forget about 2 weeks, okay? Forget about it. No one shits on Daniel Lynn ever again. You can believe that.
Look at these boys! You knew they were here, didn't you?
I'm just walking.
What the fuck are you doing here, Danny? Hey, Danny. No,
want to give you a hand. I want to give you a high five.
What's up, baby? Buffalo?
Hey, don't
touch my face.
I want to talk to you.
You're pretty crazy.
Oh! Go down, go down! He slipped! Are you okay? No, oh, calm down. Chill out, all right?
Hey! We're just hanging out, man.
What? What? Stop. It's nothing like that, Danny. Okay? It's nothing like that. We're just hanging out.
Oh! Oh, oh, you like a much fun? Oh, oh, he's tough.
What?
See what happens?
What?
What are you crying? No, don't be crying. No, no, no. See, this is what happens when you come here. Stay the fuck down. Stay the fuck down. See what happens? Oh, you stay down there. Don't cry.
Fucking sick.
What?
Now we're gonna wonder where all these times went. You know what I mean? Hasn't it been fun though? Huh? Huh? No, you don't have to say it out loud. Man, I know you love it. Yeah, it's just another couple of weeks left, boys. I was getting worried that we would never cross paths again, you know what I mean? Then you gotta come coming around our grass. You know what I mean? This is where we go to think. It's sacred. I just think that's a really shitty thing for you to do, don't you think, Donnie?
You're right, Ricky. You're right.
So I think something shitty should happen to you. Come on. Come here.
I got
you. Come on. Yeah. 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 Come here.
No!
See that? Look.
You're gonna eat it. Eat it.
Ow!
Come on. Eat it!
No!
Up here, look at it, look at it.
No!
We're gonna watch you eat that shit.
No!
No!
Oh.
Oh.
No!
Oh. 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 No! Oh, that's disgusting! Look at you! Look at you!
Let's go for that walk.
I am not a virgin. Don't look at me like I have three heads, okay? Look, I'm not exactly the exception to the rule here, Karen. Okay, this whole school fucks. All right, everybody except for you.
Why are you saying this?
Because I'm not lying. Look, hey. We always promise to tell each other the truth, right? I kind of let that slide for a little while. And now I'm being straight with you. I mean, I know you're not crazy about me when I'm straight with you and all, but...
Who have you fucked?
I never thought I'd hear you say that word before. It's kind of hot.
Nick.
I fucked your friend Sarah.
What? She's one of my best friends.
I dropped you off after a typical Friday night of cock teasing, and I stopped by Sarah's house. I mean, I was gonna explode, Kara. What did you expect me to do? Look, you shouldn't start something you don't plan on finishing, okay? Because there'll always be someone around who will. She made me promise not to tell you. But we're all getting out of here after today, right? So I don't see what the problem is just by letting you know exactly what I needed to do just to keep myself sane in this relationship.
How many girls have you done it with?
Stop counting after 8.
In the mirror, and the wall.
You don't have to be alone.
Who is the fairest one
it's
of all?
It's your destiny.
And beauty itself is dull.
You're the chosen one.
Who is the happiest one of all?
You are the one.
When happiness
Kill
lies
them.
Face down in the gutter.
Kill them all. You are the one.
I will light up the sky. Wake it from its sleep.
Are those really your feelings you put down on paper? That is so silly. Life is a portrait of an artist. Don't waste our time.
It will know true darkness cannot be dark. Black is me.
What am I gonna do with you, X? Well, I can call the cops and turn you in for all the shit lying on my desk. I could do that. But what is that really going to accomplish? You spend some time locked up, all it does is you take 2 steps farther away from recognizing you can do more with your life than to shovel this crap into kids.
We don't want that. So I guess our only choice here is to let me go.
I guess so. But the dope stays here.
It's not a problem.
Oh, that is the problem.
What do you care? They pay you nothing here. You get no respect from the people you're trying to help. It sounds like a shit job.
I get more out of whatever I can give these kids than you'll ever get out of your mind, fuck.
I gotta get going. Homeroom starts soon. Gotta see if the dog ate my homeworks.
Oh, well, for some reason, I'm guessing he probably did.
Fucking dogs.
Yeah.
Thanks for your time, Vanessa. Tell you what, you keep the wheels of education spinning, I'll keep them greased.
I'm sure it's not easy. You're trying to teach kids how to write, something you're lacking confidence in your own ability to do right now.
It's like telling a math teacher he doesn't know how to carry the 1.
Yours is a class with a lot of gray area. It's not just 2 plus 2.
So what do we do now, Harold?
We need to have this conversation. And then I'll let you get back to your job. I'm not here to screw up your world, Will. I happen to think you're a very talented teacher. And from what I can gather and from what you have shown me, I would venture to guess that you're a talented writer as well.
Thank you.
But I also know that there's an innate jealousy and rivalry among writers that I have to make sure stays out of your classroom. These kids are not your peers, Will.
I know that.
They're not your competition.
I know that, too. Where did you get those?
Off your desk, Will.
Why didn't you just ask me?
I'm asking now. And don't look at me like I don't have the right, because I do. I think some of these are graded unfairly, Will. And I want you to tell me why.
Look, we have certain options here I think we need to start thinking about. We don't need to make a decision right this second. But we've been letting this lie for too long. We should start thinking about...
Wee, I didn't realize this was such a wee situation.
Well, I do feel like we're both responsible.
That's funny, because when I was throwing up early this morning, I thought I was alone. I'm sorry, were you there? You sound like a fucking lawyer. You know, I worked my ass off 10 years to get into Wellington.
I know.
Extra homework, extra ass-kissing.
There's nothing to stop you from going to Wellington.
I beg to differ.
I brought some money in case that's the way it went.
You did?
I wanted to be prepared.
Familiar with the phrase, too little, too late?
So what happened to her?
What happened to who?
Slow White. When you guys are all finished, what happened to her?
I don't know, man. I guess she went back to her thing, you know, just riding her bike around town, giving people hugs, you know.
She never came and watched you play stickball again, did she?
No. I told you, man, she didn't go to our school, so she didn't really, you know, come around.
Pop know that story?
Yeah, it happened the September before I was in the hospital. I used to tell Pop all my stories.
What did he say?
He said it was something him and his friends might have done.
He said that?
Yeah. And listen, Pop was a real fucking hellraiser, man. Fucking like, just like me, just like you.
Apple don't fall far, little brother.
You guys got some set of balls, I'll tell you that much. Do they have balls, Jeff?
I don't know, Rick. Do they?
I don't know. I think they do. I mean, I really don't know. Let's see. Your balls. Maybe I was wrong. I don't know. So what's up with you two, man? You're obviously not showers. So let's see if you're growers.
What?
Get it up.
What the hell happened to you? Talk to me, Danielle.
Nothing.
Oh, pussy.
Hey, Daniel.
Hi.
He's upstairs. Hey, what did you do to your face?
It doesn't matter.
What?
Thank you. No. Why couldn't we? Why? Okay, we're not. Okay, I'm not. Okay, we're not those kind of guys.
What kind of guys? Guys that decide to stop taking abuse? Guys that take control of their own lives? What kind of guys are we, Barry? Me? I'm the kind of guy whose father likes to laugh at him when he comes home with cuts on his face. If he isn't too busy putting new ones on himself. Then I get to go to school and smear shit on myself. And you, what kind of guy are you? The kind of guy whose father walks out on him while he's still in short pants. The kind of guy who cowers in the corner and leaves absolutely no impression on anything. Nobody gives a fuck about me, Barry. And you know what? No one gives a fuck about you. Except me. I'm the only friend you've ever had. Right or wrong?
You're right.
What pleasures do you have in your life? Has high school taught you anything except how much this world blows? That expression's true. Life does suck, and then you do die. It's what you do before then that matters, what mark you left, and since I could give a fuck whether or not I live or die, that's the only thing that I care about.
What is that?
I want those motherfuckers to know what they've done to me. I want them to feel it. And I want them to know that it's not okay.
It's not okay.
What kind of guys? You know what? The whole fucking world is gonna be talking about us. About how we took a stand, about how we said no more. When we light up that fucking place, man, when it's their blood that's getting spilled as opposed to ours, everyone's gonna know. Those are the kind of guys we were.
Wait, the kind of guys we were?
Yeah, the chances of us getting out alive aren't so great. What were you gonna do with the rest of your life? Huh? What were you gonna do that was gonna be so special? Don't go developing dreams of grandeur on me now, Barry. You're not that guy.
What? Where would we get them from?
I know a kid whose uncle's a vet. And he's looking to unload. I can cover it.
What are you thinking?
Last day of school. First bell before homeroom. So? What are you gonna say? What do you say? You're not gonna punk out on me, are you? So long as I gave him the money. It's called big business, Barry. I mean, it's time to grow up.
What if the guy went and called the cops? What the hell are we gonna do then?
Will you relax? Listen, this happens all the time. It's harder to get a fake ID and more dangerous, believe me. So I'll be over soon.
We should start heading over there. First bell's gonna ring soon.
I'd marry you. I'd marry you and have this baby. I would. Would that make a difference to you?
I am gonna take that waitress job. It's a couple of extra bucks for next year.
Just think about it, okay?
There was this one other girl. Not long ago, maybe, was it 2 weeks? She was hanging out by the Lucky Mart by herself on, like, was it Tuesday or Wednesday? I pulled up to her and asked if she wanted a ride, you know? She looked kind of grateful. She goes to our school, but she's a loser. Not a lot of friends, you know? Doesn't get asked to go for rides too often, I bet. She had a decent body under all those creepy clothes. I mean, who knew? I fucked her in the back of the truck here and then dropped her off at the store. I mean, hey, I could tell, though, right? Like, the way she looked at me, I had done the right thing. She looked so happy. She was almost pretty. I gave her that. Actually, I've given it to her 4 times so far, Gary. Sometimes I just drive by there late at night, and she's always there. Guess the girl likes slushies.
Why did you tell me all this?
I don't know.
Did you ever love me?
Well, maybe for a couple weeks.
I don't know you.
Hey, Karen, you never really did. Hey, Karen. Karen! You're fucking tease.
You guys ready for this?
Fuck.
Okay.
What's up, man?
Franco.
What's up,
Doc? What did you mean before when you said enjoy your time here?
Just that, yo. Shit doesn't get any better than it does here.
Really? Is that a fact?
Yeah, yeah. You know, I mean, at least here you can, you know, you can do stuff, you know? You can affect people's lives. You know, out there, you're just another fucking number, man. You know, just working, chugging along, making a living.
Some days, anyway.
Exactly. You'll be here soon enough, and you'll see.
What are you doing right now?
Oh, man, I don't know. I just can't hang out here after 8:30. Fucking rent-a-cops always hassling me. It was fun. I used to go to school with half these fucks. You know what I mean?
Yeah, had some fun, man.
Listen, Rick. So today's your last day. You give him some extra hell today. Because tomorrow, these little fucks are gonna be the people you wish you were. And make him pay for that today. Am I right, Lenny?
Yeah, Frank, you're right.
See? Gotta make him pay.
I got pinched once this morning already. It's gonna be one of those days. Shouldn't have got out of bed.
Provide a service, Wax. What are we gonna do? You don't get out of bed.
Thanks, I needed to hear that.
You're the dope man. Don't forget that.
Don't you forget that.
Your lack of comprehension regarding your own story is astonishing.
I think some of those are very good. Especially considering they were written by teenagers. And all of them, at the very least, are worthy of the encouragement to continue that every teacher should be giving every single student who is willing to work.
I don't know why I would have written this. There must be something...
I hate to throw this at you, Will, seeing as this is the last day of the year, but I really need you to look at these again.
I will.
And I need their final grades to be based on a fairer scale.
Of course.
And one more thing. Ease up on the students reading their work out loud. Can be a little heavy on their psyches. Let's remember, they're still just kids. They didn't sign up to be criticized in public. Happens too much outside the classroom door to start bringing it inside.
I can see how that would be a problem.
Just be more aware of what your job is and try to separate it from the other part of your life, that's all.
You know, this is good. I mean, this is really good. I'll get this back to you by tomorrow afternoon. Is that okay?
Tomorrow's fine, Will. And you've still got all today with the kids. It's not too late.
You make me.
anytime. You know how to find me.
All right. So, I'll give you a ring, okay?
Okay.
All right. Talk to you later.
Bye.
Excuse me, Mr. Lewis. Sorry, I forgot to give you these.
Last day.
Before we get started, I'd like to talk about something. It's been brought to my attention that some of you think I've been overly critical of your work, of your writing, maybe even unfair. And I think you're right. I have been. So what I'd like to talk about is change, if I can. It's the last day of school, so maybe it's too late, I don't know. But I'm not so much a teacher that I can't apologize. And you are my students, you're just kids. And I don't mean that as an insult. It's the opposite, actually. And my job is to recognize that and to nurture it, and I didn't. I guess I forgot what it's like to be a high school student. And I don't want to be a part of anything that might discourage you or put you towards some sort of edge. So hey, guys, I'm sorry.
Don't move. And don't fucking talk. I said, don't fucking talk. I'm gonna talk. Me, do you understand? All right, not if you understand what I'm saying. Good, now get on your knees. Get on your fucking knees! Why are you on your knees, Paul? Huh? Is it because I got a gun in my hand? This gun scare you? You can do whatever you want to me. Insult me, kick me, shit on me, and the only thing I can do to get some fucking respect from you is to hold a gun on you? This is pathetic. And this is your fault. You thought I was weak. Who's weak now, huh? How weak am I now? They teach us that man evolved from apes. I think that's wrong. I think man evolved from dogs. Don't fucking laugh at me. You know what happens when you kick a dog one too many times? Go ahead, you can answer that one. What happens when you kick a dog long enough?
I don't know.
They bite.
Hey, here comes a little fucker, man. Wanna get some last licks with him?
No, just leave him alone.
Fuck that shit, man. One last time.
Just leave him alone.
I did punk out on him. I don't know, maybe there are other ways to take a stand. I hope my kids, any kids, don't have to go through what we did. I lost my only friend on that last day of school.
Now the last word that we've received is that there are 7 people confirmed dead, including one teacher, William Pratt, who taught creative writing. Now, police and ambulances arrived on the scene around 8:40 a.m., about 10 minutes after the first shot was fired, but the damage was already done. The names of the 2 shooters have now been released. Dara McDermott, who is now in police custody, was taken down and held by senior student Donnie Preetze, who is being hailed as a true hero. The other is Daniel Lynn, who committed suicide shortly after the first shot was fired. Now, Lynn is believed at this time to be the ringleader of the shooting, the 4th in the United States so far this year. The stark truth and frightening reality of the situation is that it is difficult to pinpoint where these events begin. Violent movies, video games, parental neglect, the availability of weapons could all be considered factors. But one thing that is clear, as long as there are brave people like Donnie Preetzy, there is hope for America's youth. This is John Ravinson reporting live from Riverside High School.
March 24, 1998, Jonesboro, Arkansas. Four students and one teacher killed, 10 others wounded outside as Westside Middle School emptied during a false fire alarm. Mitchell Johnson, 13, and Andrew Golden, 11, shot at their classmates and teachers from the woods. May 21, 1998, Springfield, Oregon. Two students killed, 22 others wounded in the cafeteria at Thurston High School by 15-year-old Kip Kinkle. Kinkle had been arrested and released a day earlier for bringing a gun to school. His parents were later found dead at home. April 20th, 1999, Littleton, Colorado. 14 students and one teacher killed, 23 others wounded at Columbine High School. Eric Harris, 18, and Dylan Klebold, 17, had plotted for a year to kill at least 500 and blow up their school. At the end of their hour-long rampage, they turned the guns on themselves. April 28, 1999, Tabor, Alberta, Canada. One student killed and one wounded at W.R. Myers High School in the first fatal high school shooting in Canada in 20 years. The suspect, a 14-year-old boy, had dropped out of school after he was severely ostracized by his classmates. March 5, 2001, Santee, California. Charles Andrew Williams, 15, kills two and wounds 13 after firing from a bathroom at Santana High School. November 12, 2001, Cairo, Michigan. A 17-year-old student wielding two shotguns took a teacher and a classmate hostage for more than 4 hours before freeing his captives and killing himself. January 5, 2002, Tampa, Florida. Charles Bishop, a 15-year-old boy, crashed a Cessna into a skyscraper after taking off without clearance. A suicide note praising Osama bin Laden and the September 11th terrorist attacks was found in his pocket. Bishop was the only fatality.
A world of colors, what's your plan now? Yeah.